أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون.
Translation. It is not righteousness that you turn your faces towards the east or the west, but it is righteousness to believe in Allah and the last day and the angels and the book and the messengers, and to spend of your money out of love for him, for your kin, for orphans, for the needy, for the wayfarer, for those who ask, and for the ransom of slaves, to be steadfast in prayer and practice regular charity, to fulfill the contracts which ye have made, and to be firm and patient in pain, in suffering and in adversity, and throughout all periods of panic. Such are the people of truth, the God-fearing. And in another verse in the same surah, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 254, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة والكافرون هم الظالمون. O you believe, spend out of the bounties we have provided for you before the day comes when no bargaining will avail, nor friendship, nor intercession. Those who reject faith, they are the wrongdoers. So, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Masjid Allahu Akbar's fundraiser. We have Imam Al-Amin Abdul Latif, who will take it from here.
Alhamdulillah. Welcome to all of you. Inshallah, this is our Ramadan fundraiser. It's a special fundraiser. Again, you know, in the month of Ramadan is a time, you know, to spend and to give. Alhamdulillah. It's reported that the Prophet ﷺ was the most generous of people. And in the month of Ramadan, he gave even more. He was more generous in spending and giving. And so this is a month, alhamdulillah, that we don't want to pass us without trying to appeal to the generosity of the Muslims during this month. And of course, you know, it's a very difficult time for us, or I wouldn't say really a difficult time, but it's a strange time in that this is not the norm, you know. Normally we'd be meeting with crowds of people and we'll be shaking the money tree and asking who's going to give this and who's going to give that, all right? So it's a little different for all of us. It's a little awkward, but be as it may, inshallah, I'm sure you will get the message, you know, and you will spend and give, you know, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're doing this fundraiser because, of course, we need the funds. We need the funds to maintain our masjid. You know, as you all know, alhamdulillah, we just finished it, you know. We just finished the masjid, and as soon as we finished, they closed it, they shut us down, so we couldn't open it up. So, all right, so we weren't able to collect donations, and again, to raise the funds that we need, and we still need a lot of funds. Even though the masjid is finished, we still need a lot of things, you know, for the masjid. Sound systems, office equipment, storage space, alarm systems, you know, and as well as the ongoing utilities and other many different things, alhamdulillah. So our goal tonight is to cover our expense at least for the next 7 months, you know, to the end of 2020. All right, so like 7 months. So we need to raise as much money as we can. And so our target is to raise $60,000, you know, from now until the end of Ramadan and beyond, you know. It all depends on how generous you are. All right, so alhamdulillah. Having said that, inshallah, our speaker tonight, alhamdulillah, a special guest, alhamdulillah, and he's the brother that's very dear to me, and we do a lot of interacting together. He's the imam of the masjid, the Islamic Center of Melville, alhamdulillah. So he's going to come and give us a talk and speak to us, you know, on this issue of spending for the in the way of Allah in this month of Ramadan, and hopefully, inshallah, I'm sure he will, you know, as he revealed to you the ayats and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, touch your heart, and you will spin, alhamdulillah. Then after he's finished, inshallah, our brother Shaheed will come and tell you, explain to you how you can donate to the various options that you have in terms of spending the money, how you want to send it, you know, through Cash App, PayPal, direct deposit, etc. Inshallah, so he'll make all of the information available, so it'll be very, very clear to you, inshallah, as well as the message, new phone number, and you can call us also to get clarity on any of these issues. All right.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, brothers and sisters. Please send your donations to our website, masjidallahuakbar.org. That's masjidallahuakbar.org. Under the Donate Now portion of our homepage, it will direct you to PayPal, or you can send it through our Cash App. Our Cash App cash tag is $MASJIDALLAHUAKBAR. That's $ Masjid Allahu Akbar. You can also use our Masjid phone number, which is 631-335-2190.
So again, you know, without further ado, tonight is really the night to hear from our imam, and benefit from his advice and his message. So inshallah, Imam Abdul Wahab from Masjid Islamic Center.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة مئة حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم. الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ولا أذى لهم أجرهم عند عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون قول معروف ومغفرة خير من صدقة يتبعها أذى والله غني حليم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى كالذي ينفق ماله رئاء الناس ولا يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فمثله كمثل صفوان عليه تراب فأصابه وابل فتركه صلدا لا يقدرون على شيء مما كسبوا والله لا يهدي القوم الكافرين ومثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم ابتغاء مرضات الله وتثبيتا من أنفسهم كمثل جنة بربوة أصابها وابل فآتت أكلها ضعفين فإن لم يصبها وابل فطل والله بما تعملون بصير أيود أحدكم أن تكون له جنة من نخيل وأعناب تجري من تحتها الأنهار له فيها من كل الثمرات وأصابه الكبر وله ذرية ضعفاء فأصابها إعصار فيه نار فاحترقت كذلك يبين الله لكم الآيات لعلكم تتفكرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم من الأرض ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم يؤتي الحكمة من يشاء ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب وما أنفقتم وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب إن تبدوا الصدقات وما أنفقتم من نفقة أو نذرتم من نذر فإن الله يعلمه وما للظالمين من أنصار إن تبدوا الصدقات فنعما هي وإن تخفوها وتؤتوها الفقراء فهو خير لكم ويكفر عنكم من سيئاتكم والله بما تعملون خبير
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم The likeness of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah is as the likeness of the grain of corn. It grows 7 ears, and each ear has 100 grains. Allah gives manifold increase to whom He wills, and Allah is all sufficient for His creatures' needs, all Noah. Those who spend their wealth in the cause of Allah and do not follow up their gifts with reminders of their generosity or with injury, their reward is with their Lord. On them shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. Kind words and forgiving of faults are better than charity followed by injury. And Allah is rich, free of all needs, and He is most forbearing. O you who believe, do not render in vain your sadaqah, your charity, by reminders of your generosity or by injury, like him who spends his wealth to be seen of men, and he does not believe in Allah, nor in the last day. His likeness is the likeness of a smooth rock on which is a little dust. On it falls heavy rain, which leaves it bare. They are not able to do anything with what they have earned, and Allah does not guide the disbelieving people. And the likeness of those who spend their wealth seeking Allah's pleasure, while they in their own selves are sure and certain that Allah will reward them for their spending in His cause, is the likeness of a garden on a height, a heavy rain falls on it, and it doubles its yield of harvest. And if it does not receive heavy rain, light rain suffices it, and Allah is all seer, knows well of what you do. Would any of you wish to have a garden with date palms and vines, with rivers flowing underneath and all kinds of fruit for him therein, while he is stricken with old age and his children are weak, not able to look after themselves? Then it is struck with a fiery whirlwind so that it is burnt. Thus does Allah make clear his ayats to you that you may give thought. O you who believe, spend of the good things which you have legally earned and of that which we have produced from the earth for you, and do not aim at that which is bad to spend from it, though you would not accept it save if you close your eyes and tolerate therein. And know that Allah is rich and worthy of all praise. Shaitan threatens you with poverty and orders you to commit evil deeds, illegal sexual intercourse and sins, whereas Allah promises you forgiveness from himself and bounty. And Allah is all sufficient for his creatures, needs all knower. He grants hikmah to whom he wills, and he to whom hikmah or wisdom is granted is indeed granted abundant good. But none remember except men of understanding. And whatever you spend for spending, charity is for Allah's cause, or whatever vow you make, be sure Allah knows it all, and for the wrongdoers there is no helper. If you disclose your charity, it is well. But if you conceal them and give them to the poor, that is better for you. Allah will expiate you some of your sins, and Allah is well acquainted with what you do.
After this,
beautiful ayahs.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وقائدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أمامه إن شاء الله we'll do some lesson from Ramadan. How is Ramadan?
Alhamdulillah.
Did you feel better than before Ramadan? A little bit different or big different?
A lot different.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, O you who believe, The fasting is prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you. It's Siyam is not special for this Ummah. Siyam, it's same before Ummah, before Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commanded to us fasting? He said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ تَقْوَى لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Some, he just started Siyam Ramadan, but he still keep make sense. Same problem before Ramadan, he still doing Ramadan. What's different? No different. He just like adab, he just punishment, just hungry, and no eat, no food, just hungry, just punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him. Some Ramadan say just, لَا رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَا يَنَالُ مُنْ صِيَمِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعَ الْعَطَشِ. He no reward. He just hungry and thirsty. That's it. If not change and try close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَال كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Subhanallah, when you listen to many doctor now, and he say, Siyam is health, right? Nobody doubt about Siyam is health. Before, we know, alhamdulillah, any word the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say is benefit. If we know or not know, we know all deen is benefit for us. Why is special Siyam he health? Only for body. Just when he listen to some doctor, non-Muslim and Muslim, he say, fasting benefit for body. Subhanallah. And I listen to doctor, he non-Muslim. He try too much, push people fasting. Two kind of fasting. Fasting like Ramadan and fasting just stop eating. Like 8 hours, 15 hours, just drink, don't eat. This health for your body. Subhanallah, we have this already. Ramadan, we have Monday and Thursday. We have white days. We have Zulhijjah. We have, alhamdulillah, too many munasabat. Yani, وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. This deen. Alhamdulillah, we follow sunnah. We know, if we know benefit, alhamdulillah. If not, we follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you think just fasting is healthy, it's wrong. Because if you stress, if you have something difficult, is siyam it help you? It's not help. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ فسبح بحمد ربك وكن من الساجدين واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى told the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, we know it's when kuffar tell you something, you very angry and your صدر is ضيق, it's tight. ولقد نعلم أنك يضيق صدرك بما يقولون. What they do? He say, فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِكَ فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدَ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ. Go make salah. If you have ham and gham, go make tasbih and go make wudu and go prayer to rak'ah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدَ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حتى يأتيك اليقين until you die. You have yaqeen. No anyone he lives this dunya every thing perfect. Today is good, next day is difficult. Everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We Muslim accept everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We say alhamdulillah and make sabr for good deed and bad, everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we accept everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second ayah, شهر رمضان, or after this ayah, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. This second lesson from this month, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He revealed whole Quran to السماء الدنيا and house there is called بيت العزة. After that, he came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on 23 years. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. If you fasting without read Quran, you know how? Is Quran is like ruh, like soul. It's Quran, Ramadan, it's Quran. And it's whole year, but it's special more in شهر رمضان. And علماء الحديث, Imam Malik, all علماء, he stopped before Ramadan, when Ramadan stopped, he stopped, gave lesson. No hadith, nothing. It's just Quran. What is this ibadah? This good chance to back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us one night, best than 1,000 shahr, best than 1,000 month. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr, wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr, laylatul qadri khayrun min 1,000 shahr. Jibreel alayhi salam, when he came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all year he reviewed Quran with him one time a month. But in Ramadan, he gives 2 times. He read Quran within Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. 2 times in Ramadan. Why? Because Ramadan is special. This some lesson. Other lesson. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Narrated Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he who observed fasting during the month of Ramadan with faith, while seeking its reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will have these past sins forgiven. But not only fasting, not only just read Quran without understand, read fasting and read Quran with Iman, with Mahabba, with love. You fasting not only for health. You can do health to many things, but don't focus to, oh, this is good for health, this is good for body, this is good for this. After a while, no Iman. Okay? All people make too many things health, but this Iman and Wahtisaban. Why you fasting? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told us fast. Why prayer? Is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us prayer. This, we follow deen. And last lesson, too many lessons in Ramadan, but just the last lesson I will talk about, it's nafaqah, sadaqah, donation. Two things in Ramadan, Sadaqatul Fitr, this it's only in Ramadan, and generous, more Sadaqah, and Zakah, and more than this in Ramadan. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when in Ramadan, he give more Sadaqah than other Ramadan. This is benefit. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You didn't get big reward until you give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something you love. If you have $100 and you need it, and some other one he more needed, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he know you need, and you give him. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you how much reward. Because وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَصًا. Because you give him, he need more than you, but you give him because you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر لكم. إن شاء الله, just mention this masjid. My first time I came to this masjid, wallahi, I'm very, very happy. I feel something different here because I love Imam so much, Jazakallah khair. And please be generous to this masjid, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakah and give you health and wealth. And please don't forget this masjid, please. Jazakallah khair.
Alhamdulillah, Brother Shaheed, just tell people or to inform you on how to donate. Again, alhamdulillah, the Sheikh is very, very modest, and he just wanted to read the ayahs from Quran, you know, about giving, and I think he's right. That should be sufficient. You heard the verses, he read it in Arabic, and then I translated it in English. You know, if that didn't touch your heart, I don't know what will. But let me just mention again, to give you some idea in terms of what we are about, all right? And again, Master Allahu Akbar, you know, our goal and vision here is to establish a Muslim community, you know, that provides activities, programs, and institutions to serve its needs and the needs of the people. And examples of what we're talking about in terms of establishing activities, programs, and institutions, the masjid. This masjid, finally, after 25 years of being out here in wine dance, you know, 25 years, subhanAllah, you know, worshiping Allah, you know, still doing the da'wah, still doing the work in the old musalla, alhamdulillah. But our plan and goal was to build this masjid, and we finally got it, finally. Unfortunately, you know, because of the corona crisis, you know, we had to close it down. But that's okay, alhamdulillah, the masjid is finished, it's up. But we still have lots of needs, though, okay? So again, some of those activities, programs, and institutions that I mentioned to you that we are committed to establish here is, again, the masjid, you know, to establish the salat, to establish the jummah, and to establish Eid prayer amongst ourselves, finally. No, over the years, we've been joining the Eid prayers with other masjids because we didn't have the facility. But now, alhamdulillah, we got our own, so alhamdulillah, we've been establishing that, as well as other religious programs. You know, we will be establishing Islamic education for males, females, for the children. We have all of those programs, dawah programs, food pantry to feed the needy and to feed the people that are hungry in the community. We will be establishing seminars and conferences, and we will be bringing in other scholars and imams from all over the world to come here and to teach, alhamdulillah. And by the way, you know, alhamdulillah, we've been out here 25 years, and everything I've mentioned to you, we've been doing. We've actually been doing that right from the little musalla, and sometimes we would borrow space from other masajids and Islamic centers, and sometimes we would rent hall to do all of the programs that I've mentioned to you. So we've been busy. We've been busy, and it's important that you understand that we ain't just stopped. We got 25 years of work just here in Long Island in terms of the activity that I'm talking about. But now, alhamdulillah, we have a new facility, and we can accommodate much, much more, okay? So again, we have a number of programs that we intend to implement, alhamdulillah, and add on new programs, inshallah. Our core values in terms of a community, our core values is that we are purpose-driven. You know, we're purpose-driven. In other words, we're mission-oriented here in the community in Wyandotte, okay? We know what we want. We want to establish a community that works for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Commitment, you know, commitment to the cause. You know, the members of the community is committed, their hearts, you know, and their money and their resources committed to the work of establishing the community for the sake of Allah. Another one of our core values is integrity, you know, being trustworthy, being truthful, being honest with people, alhamdulillah. This is very, very, very important, alhamdulillah, to us, alhamdulillah. And we try to maintain a certain standard, you know, good conduct and good character, you see, alhamdulillah, so that can be an attraction, you know, to Islam. You see, being an example, alhamdulillah. So integrity to us is very, very important. And the final of the core values, and we have many, but these are, I'm just mentioning four, and I want to share that, you know, with the listeners, you know, valuing people, meaning making everybody, every human being, Muslim and non-Muslim, feel valued. That's important to us as a community. You know, the Bible says, you know, another way of putting it, the golden rule. Treat others like you want people to treat you. Like the Prophet says, and I'm taught us and whatnot, you know. You know, that we should, you know, treat people like we want to be treated, see. And so, alhamdulillah, so we believe in, you know, like respecting people, giving people their props, giving the Muslims their prop, and our neighbors, so forth and so on. So again, valuing people, making people feel valued, making people feel good about themselves. So those are some of the core values, you know, purpose-driven, being committed, having integrity, and valuing people. Alhamdulillah. When we translate it in terms of our community, you're talking about real brotherhood. You're talking about real brotherhood. That's what we're talking about. When you practice real brotherhood, that's, you know, that's when you really begin to value people, because you begin to respect what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about the brotherhood, and you respect what the Prophet taught us about the brotherhood. Alhamdulillah. All right? So those are some of the things, alhamdulillah, we are about, basically. But again, the main intention today was to have a virtual fundraiser, you know, so you can spend, and again, the ayahs have been given. So inshallah, I'll have Brother Shaheed to come and tell you how you can spend, inshallah, how you can donate, inshallah, and don't let Ramadan leave without spending. And of course, people have been given even before this day, and we've raised several thousand dollars already, and we really appreciate that. You've given already, then that will be added to this year. We try, our target is $60,000. So what you have given so far, we'll add to that, you know, and we appreciate what you've given, and we're going to ask you to give some more, give again, okay? Don't be afraid to give again, you know. When you read the Quran is constantly enjoining upon us to give and spend, okay? So spend. Be like the person, you know, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Qiyamah, a person who gives so much, he gives so much that he don't know, you know, he gives so much with the right hand and the left hand don't know what he's giving. He just gives, all right? So be like that. Alhamdulillah, Allah ta'ala reward you. Remember, you know, the Prophet said that a person would be under the shade of his sadaqah. You know what I'm saying? He'd be under the shade of his sadaqah on the day of Qiyamah when there'll be no shade, you see? So please give, alhamdulillah, donate. We have to support all of our institutions, alhamdulillah. So Brother Shaheed, share with the people. Thank you for listening. Thank you for connecting with our program tonight. Jazakallah khair. Subhanakallahu wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Please send your donations to our website, masjidallahuakbar.org. That's masjidallahuakbar.org. Under the Donate Now portion of our homepage, it will direct you to PayPal. Or you can send it to our Cash App. Our Cash App cash tag is $MASJIDALLAHUAKBAR. That's $MASJIDALLAHUAKBAR. You can also use our Masjid phone number, which is 631-335-2190. That's 631-335-2190. You can also send it through straight to our banking account. That's routing number 221-473-652, checking account number 997-930-0606. This is for Project Allahu Akbar. If you have any questions on how to send the donations, you can contact me, Shaheed Hanif, at 516 area code 743-8752, or the Masjid phone number, again, 631-335-2190. You know, we encourage you to spend Fisi Bilillah. This is the month of giving. This is the month of Ramadan. Inshallah, we need all the help that we can. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair.